Hey guys, back with a new video. Today I'm doing the TFC Toys Exgraver figure. Exgraver. It's Scavenger. Let's just call it Scavenger. The first figure in their Hercules series. Now, what Hercules is gonna be? You buy six of these. They're different figures. You're not buying the same six. And then you can make the mighty Hercules when they all combine. It's their version of Devastator, basically. The box itself is nice. It's a box. It stores the figure inside. It keeps it secure. There's a picture of the toy on the back, if you can kind of see. I'm not going to waste time showing it because I don't want to see it. You don't want to see it. It's that figure behind plastic. Open it up. You get a little bio card, a little stat card. There's his stats if you are interested. It comes with instructions. The instructions are nice. They instruct you how to transform the toy, and they instruct you in many other things like, hey, that'd be kind of cool if it was that color. Personally, I like this neon green and purple G1 Constructicon look. I don't mind the color at all. I think it is rather nice. I think this figure overall is rather nice. For a third-party product, the plastic feels really solid, really nicely constructed. It feels a lot more durable than anything Fans Project has made that I at least own so far. It feels like it's an actual Hasbro product, and I really do like that. It is expensive. Let's not dance around the issue. You're buying a toy that is a bit smaller than Classics Prime. Just the wee bit. And he will cost you five times what the Voyager Prime cost in stores. $100 per figure. Six figures. $600 plus shipping for a Devastator. Depends on how badly you want a Devastator and if you can actually afford it. It is a very pricey toy, but I think it is going to be well worth it when it's all finished. Get him out of the way. For this figure itself, I dig it. I really do. I like it quite a bit. I'm really hoping that Repro Labels release some sets for this guy, because he is missing an Decepticon logo right on his chest, most definitely. But the figure itself, I do enjoy it. It does have some options for how you can pose it and display it. The accessories don't come attached when you get out of the packaging. The cap goes behind his hand in terms of the instructions. I don't know how I really feel about that. But if you don't want to have the cab there, you can go and pull it off, and you can fit it, for starters, up here. There's that. You can take his hands, and I don't think it'll peg in while that is there. No, it won't. The other option you can have, and I'm dropping pieces everywhere, if you take the hand, and you have to kind of wedge it in there. It's better, in my opinion, if you pull the little wrist connector off the hand. I'm trying it one-handed, but apparently I can't get a good enough grip on it, so I have to do it that way. Take that off, and you're going to slide it so the round end goes inside like that. Fits in there, get in as far as you can, and then take the hand that's going to peg back onto that little wrist connector. You get it there, he's waving at you. He likes to wave. You can take a shovel, and it's going to peg into his back, and get it kind of like that. Now, it does make him back heavy. You will rely on the shovel for keeping him supported in this kind of configuration, if you do have it like that. I think I can't move that anymore. So let's get it kind of like that. I'm trying to get the best way where it's not going to impair his standing too much. It's not terrible. I'm not a huge fan of this kind of look. Personally, I leave the shovel off when I have him displayed like this. But it's not bad. I've seen much worse. But yeah, I'm going to leave him there for now. For his guns, oh, and you can have the hand all closed up once you get to that kind of flush. And normally, I put the cab section inside the palm just for display. It's kind of drifted away, so I'll get it later. But that's how it would look. For his guns, you have a few options. Option one, you can have him behind his shoulders like that. Option two, and my favorite, you can have him pegged into his legs. Kind of like they're holstered. I really like that one a whole lot more. It does kind of give some clearance issues for his arms. You have him like that, but I think the overall look is better. And I just like it. I like the fact he can just reach down, grab his guns when he wants them, and just start shooting people. They do fit in his hands perfectly. Not too loose, not too tight. There's no worry of breaking anything. And you can get him, you know, just kind of like that. And there's the cap. I'm going to put the cap back on. I put it right in there. There's that. Now, he also has a battle mode, as the instructions call it. I'm not a huge fan of it, but it's essentially take the shovel off, put it on his arm. There you go. Battle mode! Oh, I don't like it. Not a fan of it, but it's there. Now, articulation for this guy, he's got quite a bit, and it's kind of surprising. First, the head is on a ball joint, so it's got that full movement all the way around. It is loose on mine, but the head, it's a small head, it's very light. While it is loose, it still holds a pose very, very well. While I'm on the head, I gotta mention something. You may have noticed, you may not have. He's got light piping. He's got lots of light piping in his little noggin, and I like it. I like having light pipe. But again, ball joint stuff. Arms can rotate all the way around. They do get kind of stuck around the top part there, but it does work fine, no problem. Due to his transformation, you can have his arms moving in this direction, or you can have him moving in that direction, if you can kind of see that. The elbow can, of course, bend pretty nice and far. The wrist can rotate. He's got waist rotation all the way around. I pinched my finger in his legs. Ow. That kind of hurts a little bit. Legs, speaking of the legs, sorry, I got distracted by something. They're on a ball joint, so they could essentially rotate a full 360 if his arms weren't in the way, but nice range movement for the legs. They can swing out to the side nice and far, and rotates above the knee, bends at the knee, and his toes and his heels are on the same kind of joints. When you move one, it'll move the other with it, which I do like. In terms of his detail, I even like that they've painted the little bits on his feet, those little silver bits you can see there. Just the detail in this guy looks really, really good. I'm not sure it's worth the money that he costs, but I do indeed like it. So there's all that there. Now, to transfer it for his vehicle mode, I'm going to go ahead and take his hand off and make it a little easier. The instructions say you should start by taking this piece up, put it like this, and then tab those in like that. I don't really like that. It doesn't seem to work that well. So personally, I go ahead and take those, and once they're already up, little slots there, little tabs there, just get them all pushed together. Give a nice hard push, and just give a push until it's a little stuck, until the black section is kind of flush with the green, to let you know it's all the way in there. And there's that. Now while that's there, you can take the hands. And I personally take the thumb, and I fold it underneath, and then I fold that little digit in, so it's like that. It seems to store a little easier, but it's going to fit right in there, peg back into itself, and there's that. Then it's going to cover the face up. Just like that. Now, for the rest of his arms, you're going to first rotate them. So this little section, the circle, and this little slot are on the inside. They're going to swing down and tab into his body right there. There's a little tab. Also, start moving this down and then rotate the hands so the green part's on the outside. When that's done, just get it there, and it's going to tab in. It may click, it may not. Mine clicked that time. So we're going to rotate, swing down, rotate again, and that, and then clippy, clippy, clip your leg clicks. I like it. This little piece is going to flip down like that. Swing that around for his legs, and you're going to squeeze those up like that. And this is my only problem with the toy. I am missing a piece. It's not an essential piece, but for the price you're paying for this, it does seem to have a piece. You may notice I have a gray tab thingy there. No gray thing in there. What that is, when you swing that out, and then swing the legs around, doop, and then doop, doop, doop. There's a little hole there. That's going to peg in. That's what keeps the treads locked in with the body. If you don't have that, let me get that line in there. Your legs or your treads are going to be kind of like this, just kind of dangling. He's a crazy driver. Clicked in, they're perfect. I keep saying clicked. Clipped in, they're perfect. It is a bit annoying that I'm missing something like. I have contacted TFC Toys. I'm hoping they'll respond to get me a new piece for that. But it still works. It still transforms. You don't really notice it until you start moving it around. So I'm not really too upset about it. For the shovel, it's going to go there. Get that up there. You can have the cab section on either side. I'm going to leave it there because that's where it was for the robot mode. And his guns will store onto his back right along there. And there he is in his vehicle mode. And I like this. I really, really do. He's about the size of a... Give you an idea. And there's Classics Prime again. That's kind of my go-to. I think everybody has Classics Prime. So you get an idea of how big he is. It is a kind of small vehicle mode, but when you compare what Prime is a vehicle mode, which I should have transformed him. I don't know why I really didn't. But he is a nicely sized... Articulation-wise for this, he does have wheels on the bottom. They do roll somewhat. I mean, it's not a... I think they're more scraping than rolling, but there are wheels there. His arm is rather impressive. This top joint here is heavily ratcheted. You may want to push down just to get some support, because I'm kind of terrified I'm going to break off the peg that's holding that into the body. But it's nice and strong, and it goes down that far or that high. And if you notice, when you move it, the piston moves as well. to give a better idea. Same thing up here, and then the same thing there. Really nice and poseable. I really do like how this looks. It's not a perfect real-world representation of what it would look like, but I think it fits in with your Classics collection rather perfectly. Now, to get into the reasons you're buying this for that almighty limb mode, I'm going to leave the arm attached, just kind of rotate it. I know I pulled it off, but you kind of have to get it up. And leave it where it's facing up like that. Go around, unpeg his treads from that little gray peg, or pegs if you have two. Flip those back down, flip those down. And you're going to take his legs, and you're going to swing them down like that. If you can see the difference there. You're going to have it so the little tabs on each side are facing each other, and then you're going to squeeze those together. It's not a perfect kind of a lock, but it's good enough for now. When that's there, take those, fold them up like that, and that doesn't really lock in place. It just kind of sits like that, which is kind of a letdown, but not too terribly bad. When you get this going, go ahead and take the hand and kind of pop it out. It just squeezes right out, and unfold all the digits. Get his digits all undone. Undo this. Those little holes that the gray peg was holding in for vehicle mode, there's now going to hold the fist. Or the wrist. There's that. And rotate that around, because that's going to be the elbow joints. And rotate the hand around so it works right. And last but not least, and this I actually like. I like this kind of look. First, flip down the little shoulder connector. The head is just going to sit in there. It's just exposed. Now, you can, of course, have the arm down like that if you desire. Give him that kind of look, but personally, I like what the instructions have. They have it, so that's there. Rotate that up almost all the way, and when that's there, swing that around, and the shovel, if you get it lined up properly, should cover the head up, and it makes it nice and solid, and I really do like how that looks. That is a nice looking arm. To give you an idea of how big this thing is, this is the Fans Project Bruticus arm. The pegs are about in the same position. Get it kind of, if I can get it turned right. It's kind of slapping around. You can get an idea of how big this thing is going to be. When Hercules is finished, it's going to be a really, really big figure. And I'm excited for it. You can, of course, if you want to have this, you can take your Bruticus, your Superion, any of your Energon combiners. They fit the same manner. It's not a perfect lock like you will have with the other ones, but it does hold together somewhat. Just give it a really good push, and it should get a grip on it eventually. Just gotta really work it in there. When you get it, there you go. It doesn't clip in. It just kind of rests, and that's gonna come off anyway, so why leave it on? Why bother? So there's that. And let me go ahead and bring this up some so you can see. Give you an idea of just how big this thing is. You know, there's the bottom of this arm. There's the bottom of that arm. It's going to be a huge, huge Devastator. And I'm so excited for it. I keep saying that, don't I? But here's Classics Prime with the arm to show you again how it looks. They're about the same. The same there when you get them all lined up in terms of how level they are. Articulation for the arm, I'm probably going to do this again when I get the actual Hercules completed. But the arm itself, it's got an elbow joint that bends like that. Nice. It does rotate at the elbow. Of course, it's going to have shoulder movement. The wrist can go forward and back somewhat, and it can also rotate. Each finger has a joint there and there. So you can have not just... You can have a lot of movement for the fingers. You can have them straight like that. You can have them bent at one joint, bent at both joints, whatever you want. Very poseable hand. It's got lots of slots in the hand. I'm hoping that's for his weapons when he gets it. And the thumb, of course, on the ball joint, and it's got an added joint right there. So, very nice and poseable. Very pricey. $600 for a Devastator. But the way I see it, it's not going to fall apart whenever you transform it, and you know the paint apps are going to be the same for every single one. They're not going to be splotchy on some parts. You won't have to touch up paint on others. It's going to be that solid color. And it's going to look good. It's going to look real good. So yeah, I would say pick it up. It will look great in your Transformers collection. The only real downside is, of course, I'm missing that little gray peg in there. And that we have to wait 5 or 6 more months to have the finished product. It's going to be weird having this on a shelf somewhere, just kind of be propped up. You know, just like the Iron Giant trying to find the rest of his body. Maybe that's what I'll do. That's what I'll do for my stories. He's the Iron Giant trying to find the rest of himself. But I like it. Get up. Big Bad Toy Store is where I got mine. TF Source has them. Anywhere that sells the third-party Transformers accessories, they will have them most likely in stock now. I would say get it if you have the means and you are a Devastator fan. If not, well, don't get it, obviously. Hope you guys have a great day, and I will see you around.